We also know that countries, many of whom are burdened by growing levels of debt, simply cannot afford to go green. Here we need a vast military-style campaign to marshal the strength of the global private sector, with trillions at its disposal, far beyond global GDP, and with the greatest respect, beyond even the governments of the world's leaders. It offers the only real prospect of achieving fundamental economic transition. And the time to act is now.
I, Charles, Prince of Wales, do become your liege man of life and limb, and of earthly worship, and faith and truth I will bear unto thee, to live and die against all manner of foes.
The Virgin, sacrificial lamb, and in a way he was obsessed with me, but it's hot, cold, hot, cold. You never knew what mood it was going to be. Up and down, up and down.
A short clip of Prince Charles saying it himself.
The genealogy shows that I'm descended from Vlad the Impaler, you see. So I do have a bit of a stake in the country.
As it were.
Since 1534, there's never been a king or queen who did not swear to be a defender of the faith, and that faith is the Church of England. In 1994, Charles said he didn't want to be a defender of the faith, but a defender of faiths.
Well, that he would like to be, in some way, a person that feels that all faiths lead to the same God. It's unsustainable from the Christian perspective. I wish it wasn't, but that's not what Christianity teaches. If he can't, in all honesty, be supreme governor of the Church of England, then perhaps abdication.
I can explain this one. Prince Charles is also related to Muhammad based on genealogy records. Some people even think he's a secret Muslim, but I don't think it's quite a secret. Here he is doing an Islamic dance. Could he be the Islamic Mahdi? They are expecting, according to their prophecies, that he will have the following attributes. This is according to all the reliable, authentic, and universally accepted narrations by Muslims, which I'll give the references below. So he will have the following attributes according to these prophetic writings of the Muslims. Number one, that he would be from the family of Muhammad. Number two, and also from among his daughter, Fatima, Muhammad's daughter. Number three, that he would have a broad forehead and a pointed nose. Boy, does he ever meet that criteria. Here he is watching the whirling dervishes. This is the Sufi branch of Islam, which is known for their mysticism. This is also featured in iPad Goat 2, which people think is prophetic, but it's really made by Islamists. Now let's see what Tim Cohen has to say about Prince now King Charles. He thinks he's the Antichrist.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tin Khan. I'm a Messianic Jew, and I have spent about 12 years at this point researching and writing on Bible prophecy, biblical history, and Christology. And I am the author of this book, The Antichrist and the Cup of Tea. It's a 444-page, heavily documented book, which I am going to share with you tonight. You're going to see that this book is literally the first book in the history of the world to give hard evidence, and by that I mean scripturally testable evidence, to suggest the identity of the Antichrist. And in addition to that, this book documents the structure of the quote-unquote New World Order and shows that all the key organs of that New World Order sit beneath something called the Order of the Garter today, which itself is built up and has been built up over a period of several centuries beneath the British monarchy.
That video is about an hour long, so I'm just going to put the link in the description. Some people think his son William is a better candidate. I will cover that in my next video, so please subscribe.
Whereas it has pleased Almighty God to call to his mercy our late Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth II, of blessed and glorious memory, by whose decease the crown of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland is solely and rightfully come to the Prince Charles Philip Arthur George. We, therefore, the Lords spiritual and temporal of this realm, and members of the House of Commons, together with other members of Her Late Majesty's Privy Council, and representatives of the realms and territories, aldermen and citizens of London and others, do now hereby, with one voice and consent of tongue and heart, publish and proclaim that the Prince Charles Philip Arthur George is now, by the death of our late sovereign of happy memory, become our only lawful and rightful liege lord, Charles III. By the grace of God, of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and of his other realms and territories, King, head of the Commonwealth, defender of the faith, to whom we do acknowledge all faith and obedience with humble affection, beseeching God, by whom kings and queens do reign, to bless his majesty with long and happy years to reign over us. Given at St. James's Palace this 10th day of September in the year of our Lord 2022.
Three cheers for His Majesty the King!